In the day's other news, anger built among Haiti's earthquake victims as thousands spent a fourth night out in the open. Many accused officials of doing nothing, and hospitals struggle to treat victims. Saturday's quake left nearly 2,000 people dead and more than 10,000 injured. We'll hear more from Haiti later in the program. There is word that suspected Islamist fighters in Burkina Faso killed at least 47 people today. The government in the West African nation says that extremists linked to Al-Qaeda or ISIS ambushed a convoy. The dead included 30 civilians and 17 soldiers and volunteer troops. Remnants of Tropical Storm Fred blew into the northeastern U.S. today with warnings of mudslides and flash floods. The system already caused widespread flooding in Georgia and the Carolinas, where scores of people had to be rescued. One death was reported in Florida. Meanwhile, the storm named Grace is now a hurricane heading for Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula. In Northern California, another community lay in charred ruins today. The Caldor fire destroyed at least 50 homes in Grizzly Flats on Tuesday and threatened hundreds more. Flames and fierce heat burned out trucks and cars and left chimneys standing alone and skeletal chairs in a gutted church. Evacuees were in shock as they gauged their losses.
It was a beautiful, close, small, vibrant community of mixed peoples from every demographic that you can think of, but a tight community, and it's nothing now.
Some 100 miles away, the huge Dixie Fire is still burning near Susanville, a town of 18,000. The Biden administration is proposing major changes to cut a record backlog of 1.3 million immigrant asylum request cases. They would be moved from immigration courts to the Homeland Security Department, which would add 1,000 new asylum officers. The proposal is now subject to public comment. One of the owners of Purdue Pharma testified today that the company and his family are not responsible for the opioid epidemic. Richard Sackler appeared at a federal bankruptcy hearing on the company's plan to settle thousands of lawsuits over OxyContin. The Sacklers are also demanding immunity from further lawsuits. The federal sex abuse trial of the Grammy-winning singer R. Kelly has begun in New York. He's accused of using money and fame to lure and abuse girls, boys, and young women. In opening statements today, federal prosecutors said that Kelly was a predator. The defense said his alleged victims knew what they were getting into. The state of Georgia has moved closer to taking over elections in the Atlanta area. The Republican-controlled State Elections Board approved a bipartisan review panel today. It will investigate elections in heavily Democratic Fulton County. Former President Trump has falsely claimed that fraud led to his narrow loss in Georgia. And on Wall Street, stocks lost ground late in the day, with major indexes down roughly 1%. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 382 points to close at 34,960. The NASDAQ fell 130 points. The S&P 500 was down 47. Still to come on the NewsHour, the uncertain future for women and girls in Afghanistan living under the Taliban's control. Anger grows in Haiti over the slow recovery following the deadly earthquake. Police reform and the key issue preventing negotiators from reaching a deal in Congress, plus much more.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.